Just a week ago, I shared my opinion on why I think Tesla is a buy and hold for this decade. In the last 7 days, oh my god, lot of good news came out and I'll cover them in today's video. Let's get into the video. Hi, welcome to Let's Make Education Free channel. Thanks for the support. We have launched a Telegram channel to give you updates on the stocks I'm currently buying and also share the relevant information you need for your personal finance management. I promise I will not bombard you with course advertisements or promotions. Alright, let's get into today's topic. Investor relation, Tesla. Tesla's 2020 Q3 results. Here we go. Mind blowing. I didn't expect such an awesome result. I'll share with you some key highlights. Automotive gross margin whooping 27.7%. What does that mean? Gross margin is nothing but sales revenue a company retains after incurring the direct costs associated with producing the goods it sells. So here, Tesla is making a gross profit of around 28 cents from each dollar of revenue generated. Remember, this is a gross profit, not the company's net profit. Usually, when gross profit margin is higher, then the company can use that money towards paying its debts, administrative expenses, interest fees, etc. After subtracting these expenses, you get the net profit. Just for the comparison, let's take NIO, a Chinese electric car maker who has the potential to become the next Tesla, in my opinion. They have a gross profit margin around 5.5%. So see how strong Tesla is. Even after subtracting the regulatory credits, Tesla's gross profit margin is around 23%. This is huge. I didn't expect this. Net income attributable to common stockholders, non-GAAP, has increased whooping 94% quarter on quarter. And earnings per share is around 75 cents. Look at this number, guys. $1.4 billion in free cash flow. This number is more important than the profit. Remember, companies go bankrupt not because they don't make profit, but because of negative cash flow. So having $1.4 billion in free cash flow is really awesome. Because of the recent capital raise, Tesla is now sitting on top of $14.5 billion in cash and cash equivalents. With this, they can easily build 10 more gigafactories if they want to. And this huge cash will help them to invest further in their product line. Next thing I want to highlight is Tesla's release of a full self-driving beta version. They did a fundamental architectural rewrite of the neural networks and control algorithms. And they released a beta version to few selected people. This is hitting huge. Already, in just a matter of few days, I can see plenty of videos on YouTube regarding how awesome the rewrite is. The car can drive autonomously even at night, and it can take care of roundabouts as well. To me, this is super impressive. Have a look at these videos on YouTube and you will understand the incredible work being done by Tesla. Most importantly, neural networks are going to get better and better when they learn using more data. So the car is going to become more and more intelligent from now on. Robotaxi is not a fancy product anymore and soon will become a reality. In my last video, I emphasized a lot that Tesla is not just a car maker. Look at the energy business. They did a record deployment of 759 megawatt hour in Q3. The strategy of low-cost solar is starting to have an impact. Energy generation and storage has brought 579 million this quarter, and it's going to continuously grow. Moving on to their balance sheet, their total current assets moved from 15 billion to 21 billion this quarter, and their total current liability is around 13 billion. Great, nothing to worry here. As per generally accepted accounting principles called GAAP, Tesla's net income for this quarter is around 331 million, which is an impressive 218% increase quarter on quarter. So this is Tesla's fifth consecutive profitable quarter. 4 consecutive profitable quarters is one of the minimum requirements for the stock to be added in S&P 500 index. Last month, Tesla's inclusion in S&P 500 index was highly anticipated, but that didn't happen. But now with this strong quarter and considering the continuous growth of this company, S&P 500 inclusion is unavoidable in the future. By the way, if you are a resident Indian and would like to know how to invest in S&P 500 from India, please watch this video. It will give you an insight about the best mutual fund in India. Tesla is currently building Model Y capacity at Gigafactory Shanghai, Gigafactory Berlin, and Gigafactory Texas. And they remain on track to start deliveries from each location in 2021. Tesla Semi deliveries will also begin in 2021. 2021 is going to be more exciting for Tesla. Please read this Q3 report from Tesla. It's about 29 pages and each page is exciting. It will give you an insight on all the exciting things happening in this company. Link is in the description. Looking at all these exciting news like 14.5 billion cash, 1.4 billion free cash flow, 331 million GAAP net income, record vehicle deliveries, first step of fully self-driving beta rollout, I'm becoming more bullish on this stock and I'm sure this stock is going to rock in this decade. I'm actually kind of worried that I don't have big money to go heavily in this stock, but it's fine. Investing or life in general is all about how best we utilize the things we have in hand and grow. So yeah, I'll continue to work hard and I encourage you to do that as well. When it comes to investing in this stock, please do your own research and take your own decision. Making videos takes a lot of time and effort. So if you're interested in posts and updates from me, then please join this Telegram channel. See you again in the next video. Subscribe and click the bell icon and don't forget to smash the like button if you really enjoyed the content. Together, let's become rich and let's make education free.